going at it. So we're ready to go, James Brayshaw. All right. Good bounce to get us underway. McDonald partially held. Thompson lies on top of the footy. And I reckon the umpire's going to want to see it again.
Stephen Baker down in the middle too, the man that, well, he can get under the skin of a few players as well, so he may have worn one from that centre bounce.
Again, the bounce was good. White down, unable to get clear use of it was Bartram. Fisher hacked it out of there. Del Santo, nicely done. Ball inches it forward. Baker, and also Goddard, around the body from that player. Dangerous bouncing ball, and Green may just see it over the line. He does.
Got a good feeling about this game today, Gary.
Oh, yes, it's going to be a beauty. Aaron Davey, I thought it might have been Baker that picked him up, but Graham has gone to him.
Chris Jones.
Thompson got a really nasty knock in the middle. He's tagging Johnson at this stage, but can't go with him.
He did, I saw that. He felt the effects of it, and he still hasn't recovered. Have a look at him. I reckon he'll come from the ground, Thompson. You can just see him picture there. As this time, Ackland sends it to the top of the square. Gehring from behind. Strong attempt. Swartz front and centre. First goal.
Well, that's a good result for the Saints. And it's what they should be encouraged to do, get it in there quick to the top of the square, get a good strong contest. You don't have to be a small man to crumb well, and Big Schwartz did it beautifully. Just watch this, no great science about it. Sharing the footy around, Ackland goes long and strong, and then Schwartz just finds himself. There he is coming in at the left of the screen. A1 position now. Andrew Thompson, the player we spoke about, very, very sore at the moment.
Big start for the Saints. Got some injuries, but still plenty of talent packed into the 22 they bring to the table today. I think the umpire wants a piece of this.
Might have been against Big Fraser, way back in the goal square.
So McLean is going to have the footy inside the 50. Davey was the target, hacked out of there by the St Kilda defence. McLean and Schwartz, I think Schwartz probably should have stuck the tackle rather than trying to belt him. McLean gets it back inside the 50 with a beautiful low ball, and he hits Nates.
Well, I tell you what, Brock McLean, boys, just marking down in your little black book, Brian, of players that have, well, if they're not arrived, they're knocking down the door. He's had touches already. Beautiful user.
David Nates. Let's see if he can get started well. Kick on the way, looks good. It's there.
Well, that's a start when you have a big focus on a player. Not that the players have themselves, but certainly the wider footy community have. Then to get him involved is the way to go. And this man sets it up. Look, the give and go. Good hands from Jeff White. And look at the use there of McLean. He's just such a poised and balanced footballer. Got a great head on his shoulders. And it's always a good sign. We say this a lot when we call Melbourne games. If Neats kicks accurately early, he's in for a fair day.
Goal apiece here at the MCG. David Neates off to a magnificent start in his game's record-breaking game, surpassing that of Robbie Flower, another Demon legend. Ackland in the middle with White. Del Santo has already had four touches of the ball, and we've only played 2 minutes. Pickett just off the back of the centre circle, sending the ball wide. Dunn in front did well to control the ball and keep Maguire out of it. Here's that man you spoke of, Gary. McLean. Robinson went short. The ball went a little high for him. He would have liked to have seen that ball delivered in front.
Four touches now. Someone's got to take responsibility for McLean. Down to you, Chris Jones.
Andrew Thompson's really struggling down here. He's had his back taped, but he couldn't even get up by himself. He needed assistance.
Ball thrown in deep in the D's forward 50. Scramble. And the high one forward from Robertson, and Meeks has gone back and taken a very, very good pack mark.
Oh dear, that's a nice sign. That's a good sign for Melbourne fans right there. He's on a very good player in Max Hutchton, but he's a big presence. And as I said, kick that first goal early gives him enormous confidence, gives the players around him enormous confidence as well. What a dream start this would be.
Big celebration day for David Neates. He's going to kick two in a couple of minutes. He has.
I'd like to tell you who's playing on Brock McLean, boys, but I can't help you at the moment, because even at that last boundary throw-in, after he had a lot of the footy, he was just sitting off the back of the pack on his own. So he's gone back into the centre. And it's either, I would imagine, maybe it's even Del Santo. Maybe they're playing just wide of each other at the moment. But here you've got to tighten up. Luke Ball, perhaps.
Beautiful conditions here at the G, and the Demons have taken advantage of that early with two David Neitz goals. White in the middle. Here's McDonald, one of their more consistent performers over a long period. White did well to work the ball forward. Here's Byron again. Now McDonald, it'll give out the back door. Bartram, been impressive this year. Goes wide, look at the pace of Davey. Needs to get rid of the ball very quickly, because Graham closed fast. Did well, Graham, look at that. Sitting on the back and found Goddard. Riewoldt and Carroll having a nice old stoush. Whelan able to just find a bit of space for Green to work his stuff out towards Dunn. Maguire there. Rivers, the third man in support cast, did well, allowing Dunn to prick it up. Here he is again. I think you're right, Gary. May well be Del Santo on McLean. And Whelan just taking his time and nice poise showing.
Dumps it in the Rivers direction. I think Milne got a good hand in there to break that up.
Centre square opening bounce. Andrew Thompson in the centre square. He's on the boundary getting taped up at the moment. Got cleaned up. Let's have a look at this.
Just the head of Baker.
Almost, yeah, friendly fire, because Baker also was slow to get up.
Scramble on the outer side. As the umpires do in the modern era, just let it unfold. White, a thumping handball forward. Voss was good. Maguire, the long ball forward, bouncing in front of Riewoldt and his direct opponent. A dangerous ball for the Melbourne defence. Carroll, who's been good in recent weeks, really went out of the footy. Got it off to Bartram. Bartram's kick fantastic to Lyndon Dunn. Inside the 50 with a left foot ball. Neitz has lost his opponent again. Left foot bouncer picked up by Fisher and escorted through for a behind.
Isn't it a different style of football played on this ground? Now, I don't know about clubs that play at the Telstra Dome, whether it's going to serve them well for the biggest game if they manage to get there, but it is a completely different setup here.
It's open. You just don't seem to be able to hide here, Gary. You're just exposed, and it creates and conjures up more one-on-one contests. It is a vastly different game. You're quite right, Fiora. Remember, he's a left footer. That's the favourite foot he's running onto. Drilling ball, Riewoldt.
And just further to that point, it's a ground that you suspect would favour this man, Nick Riewoldt, because he can get closed up, not through any fault of his own at the Telstra Dome. They just jam back on him. Much harder to do on the MCG here.
Riewoldt from directly in front. He's got 28 this year already. A valuable forward, not more valuable forward in the competition, I wouldn't have had it, but that one's off to the left. And a minor score as Rivers wants to go on with it and focused intently on what he's got to do as Riewoldt.
Kicking continues to haunt what is otherwise, Gary, a supreme package in Nick Riewoldt.
Well, he's almost a bit like David Neitz. He starts shaky, then it's going to be a long day, but if he's on song, he's okay.
Bartram, this is one of those packages taken quite low in the draft, but getting weekly jobs done now for Neil Danaher is Clint Bartram. Kick to Davey. Thought he almost had enough of it. Saints at the back. Milne ambitious to get around Davey, but he did. Gets a good shepherd now. Milne steps away. Kick lets him down. And Holland takes it at half back.
Yeah, it's a poor decision from Stephen Milne. Just really poor decision.
Dumb decision, I reckon, yeah. Gary. Whelan now. Looking for the sun on the southern stand side here at the MCG. Demons in this first quarter. Left a screen to the punt road end. Carroll and Whelan combining and just happy to just ease back into it and wait for something to transpire.
Couple of matchups. Goddard and Johnson. Young man Johnson going together. You got Green and Fiora out the wing. Montagna running with Travis Johnston.
Holland and Bruce has made a lot of ground to be involved here. Didn't end up getting it. McDonald, Milne did well to bring the ball to ground. In they drive for the ball. Baker was there with McDonald. And umpire McLaren one of the most experienced in the business, says we'll ball it up.
I think Baker might be running with Bruce. And
free kick off the ball.
They have. They picked one out a couple ago against Baker, maybe.
Yeah, may have been.
Uze at halfback swings it across. This kick's got to work. Schwartz comes in hard on Rivers. Doing some trash talking early. He might get some coming back at him. Locked up footy and holding it.
Well, he probably saved him because he would have got a bit too, I reckon, Jim. Needed to be stronger under the footy.
Uze. Look out. The big body of Fraser Gehrig runs him down.
He's got to be dropping the ball.
And now Schwartz comes through and he's banged into the turf. Hard stuff at halfback here, McDonald. In the McLean direction. Frankie Peckett there as well. And then the cavalry arrive for the D's. Bartram's wrapped up. McDonald has to go back to Pickett. He gets past Harvey. And the long punching ball in the done direction, but Maguire read it best and took a good mark.
Fraser Gehrig, very unlucky not to be paid, Brian.
That is amazing. I've seen that paid every other time this year. In fact, they've been hot on it. Voss, look at the clear space he can work with here. Couple of bounces. In the sun on the southern side. Hutchton's even worked down from the last line, but he couldn't control the ball. Neitz worried him out of it. Free kick off the ball, go to David Neitz.
Yeah, he had him by the leg.
Neitz,
got to be patient. Oh, he is. Has he got a 50?
He has got a 50, so this will bring him up almost to the 50-metre attacking line and almost within range for David Neitz, right on 50.
Yep, no doubt, within range. Not a problem in the world, distance-wise.
So David Neitz has already kicked Melbourne's only two goals. And there's a look at why.
Gee whiz, not just sure there was much
bit
there.
Bit of a hold, it was not much in it at all. Now David Neitz, let's have a look at him. From 55 metres out, not a lot of angle to worry about, nice conditions, got good purchase on the ball, gave it a nice thumping, it's there! Neitz has kicked three in a row for the Demons, what a start!
Not sure who wrote the script for the opening of this quarter, but for Melbourne and David Neitz, it's going exactly to plan. Now, the free kick, I reckon, soft. It's against Max Hutchton there, and the 50-metre was given because the ball wasn't distributed back to him properly. But look at that. He gets on song, Neitz. He kicks well early, and it tends to stay with him all afternoon. So this is just a dream start.
Three goals to the game's record holder, David Neitz. Melbourne just continuing to roll on. Jamar now in the ruck. Acklin with him. And the umpire wants it back. Amazing, Gary, that you see 50s given away for the footy not being handed back properly. It is inexcusable.
Is it ever? That ball on centre wing and now the ball back in the middle after a goal.
There's no reason for that almost ever. Del Santo high to half forward. Coming in, Johnson. Just couldn't take it. Bell got it out the back. Goddard now needs to pick it up. Bartram came and him. Dal Santo and the line pretty close. Over he goes. And gets the old trousers lowered.
Now just for consistency, this is play on from Uze. That's a free kick every time this year.
That is remarkable. And there's a nice matchup. One to have a good look at today. Holland and Gehrig. Deep. Here's Bates. The bounce almost got pinned by Baker. Got rid of it in the nick of time. Davey. Bruce through traffic. Handball, not a lot of thought. Now Harvey. Space through the middle for the Saints. Peckett's got it. He can go for Yorra short if he wishes. He'll drive the ball long. Gehrig caught behind Holland. Nudged him under it nicely. Rivers there to help. Was really good running support for the Demons.
Jamar out of side. Bruce further afield, kicks good for that player. McDonald getting plenty of it.
He just sneaks under the guard, he does it every week, James McDonald.
Uze. Long in the Robertson direction. Beautiful kick from Adam Uze. Lots of space left for Robertson.
I'm just struck with how much different footy is here. I don't know whether it's just the way it's played today, but for forwards particularly, you just want to play on this ground because you don't get this space, or you don't seem to get this space at other games that we've been watching?
I think it stood out more this year because we saw the Commonwealth Games and this game not, this ground not used early, and all of a sudden we come back here and it is a different game.
Robertson from the 50 paint. And that looks good too. They are up and about, the Demons.
18 marks to 8 in favour of Melbourne. I just want to go down the other end of the ground for a minute. Brad Green playing on the wing, being picked up at the moment by Fiora. His role is to, what they say, fold back, if you like, and get in front of Nick Revolt. You called during general play. There's the mark of Robinson. He goes back and slots it. They should have gone to Fiora. They can't allow that because forwards, as we're seeing at Melbourne's end of the ground, if you can now isolate them one-on-one, they're in for an afternoon.
A three-goal advantage early for the Demons. Still plenty of time remaining in the first quarter. Skills are reasonably good here in this game. Two quality sides operating here today. And we expect that sort of game. A little bit harder to get the clearance on this one, Chris Jones.
The St Kilda physios went and got a back brace and they've put it on Andrew Thompson, but he's just sitting at the back of the dugout, hasn't put his tracksuit on, but doesn't look like coming back on anytime soon.
Whether it's muscle damage or nerve damage there, Jonesy. Not sure, but it was unusual. The replay didn't show a lot. Look at Byron out of the middle. Just banging it forward. Robinson will lead his man to the ball again. He's got support in Uze. Used that support brilliantly. He was wrong, put it on his right. And the mark has been taken, not paid, the umpire said, didn't travel far enough. So Bates, forced to kick it long, meets one-on-one, it'll cross the goal line. And a minor score. So Bates doing some good work there.
Well, they're all dangerous, that's the key for these Melbourne forwards. They're all dangerous, so that means St Kilda backmen have to go with them. They can't make up their own mind and just zone off and just allow space for one another.
Travis Johnson, probably one of the few Melbourne players not getting plenty of it at the moment. Voss to bring it in. Long ball in the Goddard direction. Good kick. Goddard further afield to Fiora. That's not such a good kick. Green able to come in, win the footy, just thumps the handball back, but Blake the only one there. Short ball will find McGough. His kick's okay to Peckett in the centre. Saints need to get some clean ball forward, and that's not clean. Bell thumps it long. Robertson trying to win a free. Davey off the ground at the back, kicks a goal. No, I think it might have just touched the padding on the post.
Wow, thought that was through, so did Davey. Marvellous skills, decided not to pick it up, knew he'd be pinned. Now we see St Kilda on the counter-attack. Maguire says, just get out of my way.
Free kick, Bruce.
Yep, they don't argue too high.
Gee, Riz, we're on the back pedal here. If they can get the ball going quickly.
Plenty of space in the forward line. Robinson offers the lead. That's the direction he goes. Not far enough in front. Did well to get back into traffic. Then Hutchton needs support here. Del Santo and his non-preferred right side. And now Peckett at half-back.
Yeah, they've got no one pushing up from centre half forward. They've got Revolt playing deep, so they haven't got a target to go to.
Fiora back into the side this week, and Green happy to see that one to the boundary.
Was the Aaron Davey goal a point? Was the Aaron Davey point a goal? Off the ground, says it's clipped the post. And it did.
Yep.
Good decision.
20-point lead to the Demons. They've started the better. Bell. Bait. McLean and Uze. Long ball forward. Dunn's been impressive in recent weeks. Fisher's hands, not quite. Maguire, very good. Del Santo. Wrapped up. Bate gets back involved. Fisher now. Double teamed and slung to the ground. The umpire will come in.
Mate, slow to get up, Jim. Just watch here. Bang. Ooh. Head hits the ground.
20-point advantage, Melbourne. First quarter, no wind advantage to either end here. McLean can see space afield. Neats got the Jukes out, was unable to claim it though, and now Robinson at ground level might be penalised for sucking it in. He is. So this will go the Saints' way. Blake looking for the running support, decided to turn inboard and did it himself. Penetrating drive here. Goddard gets back. Rewalt dangerous at ground level. Needs support. Carroll Now Whelan out of trouble, the Demons.
Just can't get decent footy, Gaz, to either Riewoldt or Gehrig at the moment, the Saints.
No, and I reckon it's a structural thing, Jim, and they got themselves to blame at the minute.
Johnson across the ground. Bell's got to take this, and he does.
But no centre-half forward, so the Melbourne centre-half back just peels off and drops back into the most dangerous spot, which is in front of Riewoldt.
Rivers.
30 more disposals to Melbourne to this stage of the game.
Stops and he'll go short, you'd think, to Johnson.
There's something that they work on here. Unless they can play on quickly, they'll just slow it down and not make absolutely certain that they don't turn the footy over.
Bell, dangerous kick. Del Santo chops it out. Now they can hit Riewoldt. Or Del can just pump it long. I'm not sure that that was the right way to go. Slotted over the top, maybe, and Riewoldt was away, but...
Well, they try not to turn it over, Jim.
It's Whelan that's got it now.
5.5 remaining. St Kilda just have not got the machine going so far. The Demons have been spasmodic in their performance in this quarter, but have been good enough to register 4 successive goals and basically control the tempo. Rivers. Very deliberate out of the back line, and once they get to the wing, perhaps even just forward of half back, they tend to then start straightening it up. Looking for the likes of Robinson, this time it's intercepted by Ball. Wants to move it quickly. Got Riewoldt. He'll mark. Certain goal coming up for the Saints, top of the square.
Well, what you're saying is right, Brian. That is the way they want to play. Of course, wanting to play that way and executing it are two different things. And you run the danger, if you do slow it up like they have, and just look to control the footy out of your back half, well, the minute you turn it over, you're at the hands of the Saints.
Riewoldt missed an opportunity earlier. This one should be a goal, surely. 15 metres out. Boy, he used every metre towards that right post, but got it. A much needed one for the Saints.
Now, that man there, Nick Riewoldt, he, if given opportunity, looms as the greatest threat to Melbourne here. And that this is why it's so important and imperative that for St Kilda, they move the footy well and they allow him the space to work in. Right now they aren't. They've got time to fix it. It's early in the game. 14 points behind. Probably fortunate to be that close at this stage.
Match fact on Nick Riewoldt. Leads the league for marks and goals in the first term. I'll tell you what though. If he was a golfer, Gaz, his knees are trembling over a 1 foot putt at the moment.
A bit like the yips, I would imagine. Not that I've ever had them.
He just looks wobbly.
Putting yips, that is.
This is McGough. And Harvey, who's really yet to get involved in this game in a big way. And Godfrey. And the umpire wants to ping him, and he will. You've just got to move the footy on.
Well, he's got to go quick now.
McGough.
Too slow.
Sideways ball. Two ball. And the skipper's now got Fraser in some space. Ignores that. Can go over the top to Voss, or he can dump it long in the Riewoldt direction. I think it's going to go there now. And Nick got himself into some space, but couldn't take the mark. Bartram now, and Johnson. Nadeza off.
He was in nice position, Riewoldt, then. I'm surprised he didn't take it. Godfrey with the left. Neats. Couldn't quite pull it in, recovers well, needs ground support. Where is it?
Good effort.
Come on, look at that. Neats took three on and beat them all, hoping some small ground forwards would arrive, and none did. Just Robinson, who can be regarded the other way. Now the Saints on the counter-attack. Blake at halfback.
Trying to find Davey out there at the moment, guys. Small forwards, they've not got him on the deck. Peckett, long from downtown. And Ackland in good shape, couldn't take it. And the concession from the Melbourne defence.
Now, I'm not an Ackland basher at all, but it's amazing that they decide to go long on the one time that Ackland's in the square and Riewoldt's not. Good effort from Neats. He did super well, but as you called it, boys, no support. Davey having a spell, and Pickett and the other small forwards were pushed up the ground.
Makes it tough to get people to your feet when they're sitting on the bench. Jeff White. Carroll. Very stagnant in the back half at the moment.
This is a deliberate ploy, Gary, here to slow it down, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And the last two times they marked it up, this time they've worked it pretty well.
See Jeff White with the ball before, just saying, boys, calm down. Let's just get a grip on this and slow it down and pick him off one lead at a time, which seems to be a modern feature. Chris Jones.
There's Aaron Davey. He came off at the 20-minute mark. Didn't go for a walk along the boundary like most of the rest of the players do, but just sat down straight away.
So possible injury there. Keep an eye on that, Jonesy. That's important. Good pickup. Baker. Now to Milne. Look, lots of space to work with. Can he find someone? His first thought was to take the man on and set it up for himself rather than his player downfield. And he's coughed a golden opportunity up. That was selfish. McDonald and McLean combined.
And also McGough was running into the space that you want Revolt to be able to work into. I mean, that's the sort of thing that Adelaide on Friday night were unbelievable at. Working for each other, not taking each other's room, but running out, allowing space to lead into. And with all due respect to Mark McGough, I wouldn't be going anywhere near Nick Revolt.
Johnson, outside the 50. He's probably too nice a bloke, Gaz, but I know some other key forwards in recent times who may have just given McGough a blast.
No doubt about it. It's a really good point, Jim. You've got to own that area. You've got to really impose yourself on it.
Davey back on the ground, has it just outside the 50. Goes in search of a couple of options, and it was Johnson in the end that took it.
This is the son of Alan Johnson, boys, who was a two-time best and fairest winner with the Melbourne Footy Club. Former West Australian, come over from the West. Very good player. And I remember him as an ankle tapper. Just as a little boy running around the rooms, and here he is now playing senior footy.
Is there such a thing as a former West Australian, Brian?
No. Always.
Johnson from 50 to make it a really good first quarter for Melbourne. It's on its way. It looks like it's creeping left, and it is.
Just like the term former Brownlow medalist, really, yeah. Isn't it?
Former premiership. No such things as a former premiership,
right? No, you're always one, Gary.
Well, we wouldn't know, Brian.
As Dermot often reminds us. Goddard, Blake and Davey infringing. That'll be a free. It's a strange old game at the moment. Tactically, sides just working each other out at the moment. Baker didn't travel 15, so told to play on. Now Graham, normally a penetrating run. This time he gives it off to Goddard. Been playing that loose man in defence for a couple of weeks. Harvey just didn't perhaps lock the eyes on the ball for the entire time. As now ball at ground level. White. Strange things happening here at the G at the moment. And Green just spots up Bruce. Okay. What will he do from here? Not a lot of time on the clock, so it'll be a 14-point margin at quarter time in favour of the Demons, much due to the game's record breaker. David Neates kicked Melbourne's first three goals, one at the 2-minute mark, the 4-minute mark, and the 12-minute mark. And Melbourne here at quarter time in control of the game. The Saints yet to find the switch to turn it on. And at quarter time, Melbourne lead it 4-4-28 to the Saints 2-2-14.
One AFL show soars above the rest with its guest list.
Andrew Demetriou, our special guest, Bomber Thompson.
I want to be more open this year, but I don't want to be that open.
Nathan Eagleton, the ball man. The Reverend Neil Danaher.
You beauty.
On Alistair Clarkson, Bombers coach Kevin Sheedy.
I can see why people would have thought that, because I mean, you did it myself.
Say what, yourself?
Hitman.
And its expert panel's fearless critique of the game.
There was nothing short of disgraceful in the first quarter.
I think he was pig-headed.
On the Couch, Monday, live and exclusive from 8:30 Eastern on Fox Footy.
How would you like a tofu burger with bean sprouts? How would you like a delicious Whopper Jr. from Hungry Jack's?
Oh, yeah!
How about a delectable, legendary, classic Whopper?
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Or a mouth-watering double Whopper? The Whopper from Hungry Jack's in three taste-tempting sizes. Whopper Jr., classic, or double. The choice is yours.
Hungry Jack's.
Hey, come on,
bounces off the ropes. He's back in. He kicks towards goal.
With ingenious driver assist technology, an advanced active all-wheel drive system that anticipates when to engage, and 20% more interior space, the all-new RAV4 is bursting with uncompact thinking.
Join us on Tuesday night, the Bulldog with the French-sounding name,
Danny Del Rey.
Plus a red-headed player with a catch kicked a goal bomb with his very first kick.
St. Joseph's Barry Stone.
Then, join Ron Barassi for some great 1986 moments from the Fox Footy Vault. All part of your legendary Tuesday night lineup right here on Fox Footy.
Welcome back to the MCG quarter time. The Demons by 14 points. It was all about David Neek's pre-game, of course, breaking the game record held by Robbie Flower. And it's all about David Neek's at quarter time because he dominated proceedings. Kicked three goals, one in the opener, and instrumental in the Demons taking that 14-point lead in. In fact, they are pretty dominant, the Demons, all over the ground, Brian, and probably fortunate St Kilda to be in touch by 14 points.
They were. They played some pretty good football, Gary. Clearances are pretty well even there. The uncontested possessions were big margin in those there, and also the marks. Well, that was mainly due to the likes of Robinson and Neitz, who were getting plenty of it early. They got a bit of it through the midfield. They certainly controlled the aerial part of this game in the first quarter.
Yeah, and I reckon the Saints hit their strap. If they've got four gears, I reckon they're operating in about one at the moment. So hope for St Kilda supporters, if they can just structure up properly. Plenty of class still in this St Kilda side that may provide some headaches, but the Demons certainly jumped out of the blocks, and Neil Danaher would have been pretty pleased, I would imagine, with that opening quarter. Certainly pretty pleased with that man. Not only his work in kicking goals, but his work off the footy, the holding off the two or three players that we saw then was just superb. Let's head down to Chris Jones before the second quarter commences.
Andrew Thompson's still a very, very sore boy. Look, I can't see him coming back on any time soon. He got that knock in the back and he really can't even bend down. Here it is. Now you see Stephen Baker also involved in that collision there. He threw up quite a few times at that quarter time break. We saw him do the same last week. He's not that well either.
No. He is back out there and ready to go. And as you say, Thompson still on the bench. Start of the second quarter. Demons by 14 points. What can the Saints do? When will they turn it on?
Some of those big stats winners. Brock McLean, 10 in the first quarter. Uze, McDonald and Jeff White also got 9 possessions each. They've got to get some respect, and that is a sore Andrew Thompson heading for the rooms, it would appear.
He is indeed. So looks like he will take no further part in the day, as Chris Jones rightly pointed out. Ball now very much in dispute, and this is where Melbourne won most of their ball in the first quarter, the disputed contests, and we'll ball it up here. Melbourne kicking to the city end, the St Kilda bench in this, the second quarter.
Andrew Thompson, fond memories of game number 204. Yeah. Lasted about half a second.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was actually the centre. It was actually the
first bounce.
Yeah.
Quite amazing. He won't see any further action. Peckett's locked up. Tell you what, Gaz, Saints look to me like a team that want all the rewards without putting any effort in.
Yeah, which is surprising given that maybe they're missing Lenny Hayes already, because he is the absolute engine room along with Luke Ball, and they just can't seem to get anything going at the minute.
Del Santo just couldn't possess it. Here's a man who's wholehearted every time, Harvey. Back to Del Santo. Can this get him started? Left foot ball, got it.
No surprise, two blokes are called there are just pivotal to their fortunes in Harvey and Del Santo, and they just need to start to find a fair bit of the footy. Not that Del, well, he's a leading possession winner for St Kilda, but Rob Harvey started a little bit quietly by his own standards, so they're going to start winning some footy through the middle of the ground. Their forward line can still kick a winning total, don't worry about that. So, the first quarter over and done with, they're still very much in it, the Saints.
The Saints within 8 points in the first quarter. In the first minute, the Saints kicked the goal. First minute here of the second quarter, the Saints likewise. So the opening minute specialists here at the G in this particular game anyway. They need to keep it going, and they're a good chance here because they're... In fact, it'll go against them. It'll go to the Demons, James McDonald out of the middle. And he will send the ball forward. They've been very methodical the way they've moved it. Refused to hurry and move it quickly. Meets the intended target. Big pack of players. Davey at ground level. Unsighted in the first quarter. Gathers this near the boundary line. Goddard's got it covered. And over the line, out of bounds. Well, the boundary throw in deep.
Where it needs to be, Aaron Davey, at the front of that big pack. That meant those two men go at it, Neitz and Hutchton. The ball will spill. It'll spill forward. That's at the other end of the ground.
Picked up by Del Santo. Didn't clear the area. McLean, a snap and misses.
To the near side.
Luke Ball looks like he may now have gone on to Brock McLean, which is a terrific matchup. McLean was superb early in this game.
Goddard to bring it in. Normally uses the ball well. This is no exception. He goes long to the big Goose Maguire. Couldn't take it. Footy on the ground. He can get back involved here. I think he may have given away a free, Matty Maguire. Manhandling Bartram when he didn't have the footy. And Clint Bartram will take it. In the centre. Just takes off. Gives to Uze. Short ball from that player was a little fierce for its intended target, Johnson. Battling now with Goddard. He turns Goddard inside out, Johnson. Long ball forward, dangerous spot. Hutchton in the air. Robertson on the ground, thumps it into the post.
Boys, I reckon we're going to put a bit of heat. It's not entirely his fault at the moment, but Fraser Gehrig has got to start to get himself involved in games of footy. He can't be be passive in some way, not so much about possessions or goals, but he's got to impose himself on the game in some way.
Have you been down there, Gary?
No, I know, that's what I'm saying, but in games gone by, it's been a while since we've seen that big physical presence.
Look at Graham kicking to his own man. Bruce recovers the ball. Oh, no!
Well, I was looking at Fraser, to be honest. I thought they were going to clear it from defence. Talk me through it, please.
Well, Graham, as you see, take the kick there and just basically kicked it into his own man. And Bruce recovered the ball. And this is a good look at it from here. Get a good look at the idea here. And Bruce, ever the opportunist. Thank you very much.
One for the highlights reel for Jason.
Just travelling at the moment, the Saints. Melbourne, with 11 scoring shots to 5, should be further in front. Blake got it out to Baker. Baker stripped the tackle of Pickett. And to half forward, and here's Big Fraze. Holland with him, and Holland won it. Uze over the top. Holland will get it back. And he's got Johnson. Will use the run of this player. Got a bit of his old man about the wheels, Gaz.
Nice, nice mover.
Gets it in the Neitz direction. Got the hands extended, couldn't take it. There's Davey at ground level. McLean involved as well. May actually have been bait. Yeah. And I think the free kick's going to go St Kilda's way, and Baker.
Ball. Graham was iffy at best. Eventually sees the option out wide in Goddard. Goddard could have probably kept going, dropping the ball just as Graham was to go.
Oh, this tackle in the competition, James McDonald, or he has been over the past 5 weeks.
Goddard's been booked here, Gary.
50 metre into report. And I think they've given away, I'll get our stats guru on this, but I reckon they might have given away more 50 metre penalties than any side in the competition. That is a great tackle. He has been sensational.
Let's have a look what the report's for here.
A little right
on the way up there, and James McDonald will be the recipient of the free. That true half forward. So just at the moment, Gary, it's really frustrating. St Kilda are a very good side. There's one side out there playing for each other at the moment, and the other one thinks they are, but they don't understand the true meaning of it, I don't reckon. McDonald, short ball, intercepted by Voss. It doesn't mean to say that they can't get things happening at some stage during the game. You feel like they're going to, but Who is the person that's going to provide that initial electricity?
Bartram. Grant Thomas, I reckon.
Goes wide to Neitz. Neitz from 50 near the boundary line. Drives the ball. Goal number four for the record breaker.
Oh, dear me. Sometimes these big games come around and it doesn't turn out to be your day, but David Neitz has been nothing short of sensational so far, and just to bang that one through in front of the members, no better feeling.
That's sums St Kilda's day up there, I reckon. Gaz, it's a 50-50 rock, and Bartram just wanted it more.
What about this from the big man? Outside 50 in front of the adoring masses that have come along to see this game. Beautiful to watch. There's Robbie Flower, the incumbent. Was he the incumbent? The old games record holder anyway. And the Neitz family just celebrating the big fella's fourth for the afternoon.
He is putting on a nice old display in the celebration game. Del Santo to half forward. Bounces in front of Fiora. Awkward bounce, always going to be tough to control. McDonald, long ball. Someone needs to present up. No one does at the moment. It's bouncing over the line.
Great result. Much better to do that than try and pick out something that's less than 50-50. Players get down there, they set up again for a new boundary throwing.
Almost twice as many hard ball gets for the Melbourne Footy Club, and it looks like that. Jamar at the back tries to hook it in the Bate direction. Just hands let him down right at the end. He'll get it back though, Bate. Belts on through, gets the handball towards Neitz. He goes up the ground and kicks it.
What is going on here at the minute? Big Nita just raises the eyebrows and says, I think it might be my day somehow.
Oh, yeah.
Just got five lazy ones.
He's kicking them out of the toilet at the moment, Gary.
Got five stinky ones inside the 10 minutes of the second quarter. This is ridiculous. Have a look at the big man. He's just going, hello. How long's this been going on?
David Neitz has set the G alight here on a Sunday afternoon, kicking five goals in one quarter and 9 minutes of football. As Peckett, inside 50, Rewalt dealt with off the ball, Carroll nails him, now Rewalt nailed him, did not handball it, did not kick an umpire, should be a free kick. St Kilda players asked the umpire why not.
I agree with you, that prior opportunity, I did get a boot the ball.
He did,
so good decision.
Okay, unbelievable scenes here at the MCG with the Demons absolutely on fire.
McLean just gets better and better. Left foot out of there. Voss on his own.
Yes, kicked the ground. Mick McGuire stopped. And coming in, Byron to make him pay. A couple of bounces, handball to himself. Umpire lets it go. Fierce contest out of sight. Fisher to McGuire. And McGuire's over the line. He'll be thrown in.
What was this from Brett Ross? He's missed the footy. Oh, dear. It's not going well. It's not going well for the Saints. Great chase, Del Santo.
Throw in. Jamar to the back. Peckett, a little handball. Saints in control here at the moment, although it's dangerous. It's in a half forward. Goddard in the book. Players running towards the members' side. Baker's one of them. He's got some room to move. Someone's got to hit up. Goddard's run hard. He's got Gehrig over the top. Has to go into the pocket to get him.
Left footer from the pocket. Now, he's got the footy, so that's one good thing. I'm not sure whether it might not have been better to head towards Rewalt. First touch for Big Fries.
He runs around. He's going to go with the right foot attempted banana. Just kicked it straight into Holland. They've got to reload here, the Saints. That's a man bouncing the ball as he was tackled. It's all unravelling for the Saints.
Bate. Can they make them pay? This will bring the Demon faithful out of their seats if they're not already done. Neitz!
The Dukes, Brian!
Oh, extension of the fantastic. David Neitz will line up for goal number
This is quite staggering. He has been absolutely superb. He's done everything. This sums up his career in lots of ways. He has not been overly spectacular, but he's been outstanding.
This will make it 3 goals in each quarter, Neats. Have a listen to the fans go off here. If successful, he's missed. Blot of the copybook. And just the minor for the big fella.
Does Max Hutchison stay there with David Neats?
Well, they're going to have to chop off some of this supply, Gaz, or it doesn't matter who they put on him. He's going to end up with 12 or 13. There is Maxi. Again, it's a double coverage out there, broken up by Bruce, Johnson and Fisher. Fisher hovers over the top of the footy, players wrap him up and it'll be bounced. McLaren, Meredith and Wen in control this afternoon. Hacklin and Jamar. Godfrey, a bit too fierce for Johnston, who still has yet to work his way into this game.
He unbelievably has not had a possession, Travis Johnston. Now, these two boys been at each other, well, not at each other, been on each other all day. Honours with David Neats, clearly 5 goals as well as 8 kicks and 4 marks.
Just on Travis Johnston, he's played 60% of the game so far, so basically coming up to a full quarter. Has not touched it, as Gary mentioned. Staggering from one of your premier midfielders. Fiora to Graham. Graham always a penetrating run. Handball's a little ho for Harvey. Harvey has the composure to find Milne. Oh. And it was barely 15.
Gee whiz.
I reckon it was about 8.
That is...
And just Matty Williams saying to the umpire, well, he kicked it from on the blue line. And here we are here. I don't know.
I reckon when a team struggles, and it happens both ways, umpires are humans as well, and they can sometimes err a little bit.
Let's have a look at Milne, who's normally very straight from this position, but not today, so things for the Saints just not working out. They're 28 points adrift.
Lamentable first half so far from a St Kilda point of view. Really would be disappointed with this. And the fact is they're still 28, they're only 28 points behind, so they're in touch.
Johnston's got himself a possession now, but it's not good. Kicks it straight to Harvey, who coughs it up. He's dropped a couple of uncharacteristic ones. Robert Harvey, bait steps on through. Neats will get on his bike now. Kick in that direction, Neats! Oh, this is a display, it's a clinic.
Well, some suggested that he was gone, David Deeks. There was a suggestion early in the year that his career was just about over. In fact, one opposition coaching staff member suggested the Melbourne forward line was much better off without him. I think he's putting that to rest today.
Ooh. This for number 6.
Let us in on that name shortly, will you, Gary?
No names, no pack rule.
Distance won't be a problem. Accuracy, also no problem. Neeks has got 6.
Well, the contrast in the two forward lines is the thing that is most staggering. You've got David Neats at one end. When the ball goes forward, he has got the proverbial acre to work in. Ball comes up the other end. You've got Nick Riebold, who only 2 weeks ago kicked 9, who's running into the back of the likes of Milne and McGough and Gehrig. I mean, it's unbelievable. This bloke is he's a champion.
David Neats kicked 3 in a row in the first quarter, has got 3 in a row in the second quarter, and they now lead it by 34 points with 11 minutes remaining in the half. The Demons, Del Santo.
Look at that. Look
Riewoldt,
at the contrast.
Nuts under the ball, but Gary, has he got clean hands? No! Pushes himself from an impossible angle, straightening ball. Whelan committed the body. Now Milne tries to take them on. Caught in the tackle.
Well, again, Fraser's got to do more, but the contrast, the kick out of the middle, and it ended up, Riebold was one-on-one, and then Gehrig's man, Holland, comes back and causes a spoil.
Ball bounced. Hooked out of there again. Fraze has a little go at it. But Uze will end up with it and just pump it long. Schwartz stands under it, though, and takes the mark.
16-8 tackles in the second quarter in favour of Melbourne.
Schwartz called to go. His ball will land at centre-half forward. Revolt in good position here, but he couldn't take it. Pickett stands up in the tackle. Bate makes an ordinary handball work. Carroll out wide to Davey. And he's wrapped up by Graham, but he's got it. Johnston further afield. He's had none of it to now. Sees Robertson, good kick. Robertson can dump it long to Neitz. Does so now. Neitz, is he being held? Almost took the mark anyway. Godfrey comes through and sockers into the post.
He had that cover, David Neitz, too, didn't he?
Well, he is.
Unlucky not to get a free.
There was a case for that, but when he got six, I guess, well, you're just going to pay him.
Well, you said the umpires are human, Gary.
Well,
they look at that and say, he's had enough so far.
I reckon, Brian.
Well, that's what I felt.
I felt like that.
All through my career. Harvey. Bruce. Uzay just collecting the ball wonderfully well. At half back, the Demons, they're going to get themselves into trouble if they're not careful now. Whelan got time to sum up the kick down the line, but nothing presents. Dunn eventually does, but really he had nothing on. If you look down the field, you'll see that only Dunn was amongst four St Kilda players. So in the end, probably a good result.
Maguire going to play, well, he's going to play on David Neitz. The swap has been made, I think.
Peckett panicked a little. Travis Johnston trying to find his way through the ball, and eventually it goes out.
See, their tackling and attack on the footy has been the thing that's probably improved most for Melbourne this year, I reckon.
J-Mar might have been infringed. He was. Bruce brings the footy away. Low ball. Good one, too. Robertson.
Great mark, isn't it? Well, Maxi Hutchinson just been shifted under Robertson.
McLean in some space as he snuck forward. They just look a better oiled unit. The D's?
Yeah, well, they look impressive. They certainly look impressive against this side, and they play this ground really well, and I reckon that's been a significant factor in the score to date. I'm not sure that the Saints do.
Cohesive. They're all heading in the one direction as Brock McLean. This is a tight angle. Set shot to the city end. He may have just pulled it a little left, and I think the St Kilda defence have conceded a behind.
So 7.5 remaining in the half. Del Santo, he's told to play on and got himself out of trouble against two Demons that would normally eat you in McDonald and McLean. Goddard, nowhere to go, has to concede. Backwards to Graham. He's got Acklin as a running supporter if he wants. Elects to back himself to Fiora. Strong overhead.
Really strong grab. It's centre-half forward is where they're lacking. They're getting no drive.
Well, we were going to find out about it because that's where it was heading. But a brilliant smother by Cam Bruce sees Acklin have to reassess situation. Goddard. Short ball.
It's the sort of footy that Hamill always presents to when he plays. That is one of the things they're missing out here, is someone to push up, get the footy that then goes to Revolt.
Luke Ball from 50 metres out to the goal square. Not sure he couldn't have kicked it a little harder. Rivers, Holland, Carroll, kick cut off. Del Santo now, he's got the set shot. He kicked one from there on the run in this quarter. The first goal of the quarter. And now a chance to just steady the ship a little.
A little fortunate. I think their goals have come from Melbourne turnovers, basically, in this game. Well, not all of them, but quite a few of them, and they'd be thankful for it.
Nick Del Santo. Here's a look at his work. Good angle we've got for you. Kick on the way. Looks very, very effective indeed. Del Santo's got two in the quarter.
Well, Carroll would be disappointed with that. He had bait on as a longer option. Del Santo's probably flying the flag almost single-handedly, I'd reckon, at the moment. It worked it pretty well, shared it around, and then Nathan Carroll went... Oh, we just kicked it inside of Brock McLean. I think bait was on beyond him if he needed to go to that, but lovely finish from Del Santo. And look, 30 points, it's 5 goals. We saw yesterday that margins don't mean much, but closer than they should be, I reckon.
Nick Del Santo, a couple in this second term to keep the Saints somewhere near it. White just stands his ground and then bangs it forward. Had 6 disposals and a couple of goals in this quarter, has this man. This will be his 7th. Very, very good player. Long ball forward. Melbourne defence thump it away, but straight into the hands of Fraser Gehrig, who walks in and kicks the Saints 2nd in a row.
Just want to have a look at this when the footy goes into St Kilda's forward line and compare it to some of the other times it has. Clear clearance from this bloke who's just lifting. They're all moving at least, and they've got some space. Give a contest, Fraser Gehrig gets out. I reckon they can still do it better. It wasn't as good as what I thought it was. They just have got to spread this Melbourne defence and allow these blokes to compete one-on-one.
It's back to a 24-point margin, and the Saints with successive goals.
Oh,
out of the middle, James McDonald meets the target. Maguire working him under the ball. Change has been made there, and now Fisher combining with Hutchton, and Maguire had to stop and prop. Beautiful kick from Maguire. Finds Lee Fisher. Handball wide to Baker. Little chipping ball. So Saints are starting to gather a little bit of momentum, a little bit of spark. The running handball to Lee Fisher. A bounce inside 50. Popped it to the top of the square, and the fist by Rivers was solid to the boundary.
Yeah, and your point earlier about Nick Riebold taking control down there. Uze, the player that's just sitting in front of you at the moment, he has to bark at someone to come and draw him out of that hole. It's for the good, it's not selfish, it's for the good of the club if he can get that structured up for himself.
Thrown in to the front. Montagna tried to shovel a handball out of there. Johnston ducked his head, so no free. Davey. Look at the movement of this young man. He'll get a shepherd, or he should have. Wouldn't matter, because he kicks to Neitz. Maguire did well to break that up, but the working forward, Godfrey, just couldn't pick the footy up. Still can't pick it up. Johnson can. Very nicely done by that young man. Back to Godfrey, who's in all sorts of trouble. And the umpire elects to bounce. It's a like about young Johnson.
Yeah, he's a good size. He's put on some weight over the past 12 months.
Robertson and McLean. Robertson got a half kick inboard. Good physical contest involving Bartram, and now Goddard to the back, and Voss gets around and then slots the low one but misses his target, and Johnston takes it on the wing.
Centering ball is good to Wheeler. They'll need to get on their bikes to catch him. Whelan senses an opportunity from beyond the arc, sends it home.
Not sure how many he's kicked in his career, Matty Whelan, but spent a lot of it in the back pocket and done it very, very nicely and well. He's one of the underrated players.
10 before this, Gary.
So he just jags his 11th. A nice finish it is too from outside 50. And he might just head back to Stephen Milne when he gets back on. Stephen says, I'm one up on you after the argy barge. I tell you, I like Bartram. He is hard and tough in the middle of the ground.
Ball bounced as the Demons look like they're going to take a pretty good first half lead into the long break. Del Santo, a couple of bounces. Nothing to go to, so he's got to concede dangerously too, back in the Fisher direction. He gets it to Baker, and Baker's got to dump it off to Goddard. Long ball inside the 50. Revolt's got a couple of feet. He got good hands to it but couldn't take the mark. Whelan to Uze to pick it. Byron goes to Jeff White as a couple of numbers back now for the Demons as they try and nurse this 30-point lead into halftime. Kick in the McDonald direction. He couldn't take it. Good stuff from Del Santo again, although he's paid a price for that. still down as Montagna stripped to the footy. McDonald went and got it to Uze. Further afield to Johnston. If it bounces, he's away. Kick in the Goddard direction was very clever.
They're enjoying a rich, rare vein of form here. Everything going right.
Goddard long. Neitz has got about five to beat in the air, and that was almost going to be tough. Fisher to Graham. Still, they work hard. The Melbourne forwards. Johnston picks it up. Around the body he goes, and Davey will get on the end of this. Squares it to White. And White too far out to score from the set shot, you'd think.
Well, I reckon he'd almost be a chance if he gave it a ride.
Sees something he likes. Oh. And a beautiful kick right into the breadbasket of Brock McLean.
Sums it up. Neitz competed one against five, and they still came up with a footy, Melbourne, through Johnston, I reckon it was, that got the crumb. Ball comes back out. They've still got a lot of numbers in Melbourne's forward 50, and they still find McLean. It was a hip and shoulder from Johnston that got Del Santo and made him a bit sore.
So Brock McLean to make it a six-goal lead. Kick is there, I reckon. They are rolling on, the Demons.
Still a lot of footy to be played, but there's a Queen's Birthday Monday game coming up, Melbourne versus Collingwood, boys. It shapes as something pretty special if it continues on in this vein, but as we saw yesterday, I suppose, you never write a side off, but they are giving no indication, St Kilda at the moment, that they can gather in this lead.
Jason Blake taking a spell there. 36-point margin, minute 20 remaining in the half. Melbourne in complete control at the moment. Just keep waiting for something to happen for the Saints. And
yeah, be in trouble with it.
Other than this man here, it's just not happening. Ground level.
Now, he is the loose man playing in front of Nick Riebold. Riebold should be able to contest that football from Del Santo, one out with his opponent. That's the structure they need.
Bartram has given the Demons some real spark this year as Fisher sees the ball to the boundary and will throw it into neutral territory on the wing.
Win the footy out of the middle, you've got to give yourself every chance of getting it forward. Chris Jones.
Well, you just saw Jason Blake there. BT mentioned he had a spell. He's actually injured his right shoulder that's already strapped.
Pickett slung but got it to Davey. Davey very cleverly to McLean. He goes with the look away. McDonald head over it. Claimed now by Voss. There'll be a bounce.
Now, Jared Rivers down here in front of, 15 metres in front of Nick Riebold at the moment. It is the situation that Melbourne would be happy with, because that man, Riebold, he's not going to get to compete one out with that man over there, Rivers, on his own.
White. McDonald just keeps finding the ball. Uze. And Godfrey. Off to Johnston. Johnston, beautiful kick. He's a clever player. Off a step, that is wonderful delivery. And Robertson slammed into the turf. He'll go back and try and spot something he likes inside the forward 50. Long in the Neitz direction, the kick will fall short. Bounced awkwardly for the champ, who's got six. And Voss now has got McLean to worry about. He's slung and got the handball away. Over the line.
Tackling being first rate from the Demons. And he had six more inside 50s, Melbourne, than St Kilda. It's just the way they go in.
6-goal to 3-quarter in favour of the Demons. Acklin, no time left, or there is, for one kick. Siren sounded before Pickett took it. And there'll be no further score.
Now, he called that, he didn't pay the mark, which would have been line ball with a siren. Now, was the mark not paid? That's what the boys are arguing about, because it was touched off the boot, or because he said it didn't go 15.
And they didn't have time to say play on, so I think there's some conjecture here. The Melbourne boys are still saying, well, come on, guys, but they're not going to get a win here. The scores are going to remain as they are. McLaren, very experienced man, would know exactly the call, and I think they got it right. So at half-time, a 36-point margin here for the Demons.
It is indeed, and the skipper will lead them off. A lot of work still to be done, but in terms of, as I said earlier, if you've written a script, you'd have Neeks with 6 goals at half-time, and that's the case. 36 points the margin in favour of the Demons.
Monday, a massive 2 hours of live footy talk kicks off with White Line Fever at 7.30. Then at 8.30, On the Couch brings you the latest from footy heavyweights Jared, Mike and Robert as they assess the weekend's games and welcome no-nonsense saint Max Hutchison. 7.30, White Line Fever, 8.30, On the Couch, live and exclusive, Monday.
Are you under 16 or over 70? Lived in the UK for over 6 months between 80 and 96? Had a tattoo in the last 12 months? Are you pregnant? Are you low in iron? Or do you have a serious heart condition? No? Congratulations. You're one of the few Australians who can give blood. Call 13 14 95 because your donation can help save 3 lives. It takes someone special to give blood.
Another moment of genius from Toyota. Most memorable grand final moment of all time. Specky of all Speckies, taken by a
number. Yes!
Alex Jezalenko. Dave, it's 1970, Blues versus Pies. Now, Jezzy, you stand here. I'll be Mackay. And Dave, you can be Jerga Jenkins. Happy? It's not... Dave, that was a really good suit. You've lost a little bit of the spring in your step.
Spring!
But I think all we need is leverage.
A little bit of leverage for Jezalenko! You beauty!
Oh, what could go wrong? Nothing. No, that's not going to work. Not much height there.
No, it's time for plan B.
That's beautiful.
Mackay kicks it to the wing position. Oh, Jezza! You beauty!
Hey, boy. Boy. Wow. Hey.
Yes.
Nice grab.
Now, when you close your eyes, do you see Wayne Carey?
Oh, try not to.
Now, when you close your eyes, do you see Wayne Carey?
Central Rewind, Wednesday on Fox Footy Channel.
Well, Brian, this
who
is
will
a
be Gary. Who will step up out of that?
Oh, well, that man's the obvious one right there. Not the one on the left, the one on the right. And that is Nick Riewoldt. I just wonder whether they need maybe to push forwards all the way up, which is becoming a trend in footy at the moment, to push him up around 50 and let him work back towards goal, because he's not having much joy working up the ground because Melbourne are just filling up that hole and space.
So the point there being you get defender in two frames of mind. Either he's saying, well, I've got to be ready in case he goes forward, but also I've got to be ready in case he goes backwards.
Well, the minute you run back towards goal with the flight, then all the cards are stacked in your favour. The defender doesn't, he can't turn around and watch where the footy is, because the minute he does that, he loses you. Just got to mix it up. I reckon I saw it last night with Jonathan Brown. He mixed it up on Preston Giacomo halfway through the second, and the game changed. But right now, that's a better setup. A much more space for Nick Riewoldt. At the other end of the ground, they're going to find a way to stop that man who's on a roll with 6.
Start of the second half. Demons by 36 points. White to McLean. Del Santo, who's been one that has stood tall for the Saints here today. Green went in and the Saints converge in numbers.
Adam Uzay played most of this game on the half forward, then pushing up into the middle. Stephen Baker, one of the best in the business, tagged him. He's racked up 18 possessions already.
36 seems a long way back, Gary, but they only have to work half that margin off in this quarter and perhaps save some for the last quarter, so they don't have to grab it all in one piece, if you like. Ball at ground level, Montagna. If they can just win this quarter by 15 or 20 points, McGough would give them some chance coming to the last term. Green and Rivers. Uze, normally very good by foot, around the body without a lot of thought, and Del Santo stands to mark.
Been very good today. Short to Montagna. Eyes darting around as he tries to find an option. Now he concedes distance to Baker. And Baker kicks a high one, marked by Fiora. Big flood now of players for Melbourne. What they do is they don't want them to get that first 2 or 3 goals that gets them on a roll.
Fiora steps around and then bangs it long. Riewoldt direction, Rivers was there. They managed to keep it in, the Saints, and Carroll tried to act as if he was stepping in and out and all around.
but the boundary line, the best result.
That's the St Kilda lineup to start on the sidelines. Thompson, we know, won't play any further part. So effectively, three fit players for the Saints in this second half. Bate, Davey. Skill by foot, not what should have been. Baker, inside 50, closing, 45, low ball. Punched away. Opportunity missed there.
This is the changing face in footy. In years gone by, even when we were playing, you know, if you had a six-goal lead at half-time and you play conventionally and they bang on two quick ones, all of a sudden the game, they're back in it. And this is what Melbourne are doing here. Regardless of their forward line setup, they will not, at all costs, allow St Kilda to get that bit of a roll and momentum that can set them on the way to peeling back that 36-point lead.
McDonald. Uze. And Brock McLean, who had a big first half. Jeff White. Beautiful pickup from a big man. Dangerous kick, this one, to McDonald.
Help each other.
Got it to Milne. Milne with a burst of speed. Inside the 50, but Uze can stand his ground and take what was in the end an uncontested mark. Byron Pickett in some space.
They struggle with this, the Saints. It's been pretty well documented. They struggle to work a way through this big flood.
Look at these players racked up to get the footy now. Johnson's one of them. Long ball for Neitz, and why not? Look at the hands of Neitz.
Well, because at the other end of the ground, when there's that much of a flood, you'd reckon they'd peel at least one back in front of David Neitz, but they all got stuck in the middle, halfway between nothing, these St Kilda players. And it went past them, and Melbourne had two players inside 50.
This man has six already. And a couple of them have been from outside the arc, so he's in good touch by foot. And have a look at this.
Gee whiz.
He is absolutely on fire.
It's been an absolutely superb display by David Neitz. But again, I'm very critical. They had three or four St Kilda players across the centre of the ground when Melbourne had all but two players four to the centre. Not one of them thought to go back and become loose in front of these blokes here, who have been the dominant, or in front of this bloke, who's been the dominant player on the ground. You're going to work out a way to counter this better, the Saints.
A career best seven goals against the Saints for David Neitz, the skipper and games record holder breaker here today. McGough out of the middle. Of course, he holds the most goals kicked for the Demons, that record broken a few weeks ago. And now the game's record. Ball held on to his opponent then, Rivers. And the advantage paid to McLean. Sees Bruce out the corner of the eye. Dunn trapped it really well. The little give. Look at the help for each other. Sweep it on. Help each other out. That's the significant difference from these two sides to me. Just the passion and the big goal at the end for each other. The Demons can see it. Not sure the Saints can. Bate driving ball. Byron. Up he goes against Voss. Ground level ball now. Very much in dispute. Graham. Did well through a little bit of traffic. A long kick to centre half forward. And look at that. Rivers.
Jared Rivers. I really like the look of this boy. Bate. Just got composure and a bit of touch by foot and doesn't look like he's overwhelmed. And the free kick's been picked out. Rebot may have been away, but it'll come back for Nick Del Santo. And from a St Kilda point of view,
so Troy Schwarz, I think is Rivers' opponent. He's got to go and engage him and take him out.
17th disposal.
That doesn't help.
For Del Santo. Schwartz now, Gehrig the long target, got the hands to it, it was broken up by Holland, who's been pretty good. There's Bate again, released the footy, Bell over the top of Harvey, well done McLean. He's a good, tough, hard footballer, Brock McLean. Now, Adam Uze goes in the Dunn direction, he dropped what he should have taken, a handling error lets him back in it, I think he may have given away a free.
Yeah, he'll learn from that. There's a good hard nut, but he took his eyes off the footy, Lyndon Dunn.
The amount of time Baker has got the ball in this position, Gary. Look, Baker's a great player, but you need your point guard, your best kicker to get it in that position. Has Montagna stepped to the line? Holland, did he get a hand? Yes. Just back to my original point. Baker in the middle is basically the point guard of basketball, if you like, distributing the ball either side. It's got to be one of your main players, surely.
Well, he's with Uze. Uze's playing half forward, but a fifth midfielder sweeping behind the footy, which frees Baker up. I don't reckon Melbourne are all that worried about Baker getting possessions. They'll back Uze's possessions against his like that.
Bell has it at half back. Lyndon Dunn takes his bell, Gary. Yeah. Just might get on the phone.
Keep your eyes on it. Will be a simple message. They like him. They rate him. He's a good, tough, hard lad. But just took his eyes off the footy.
Will he know that anyway, won't he?
He will, yep. But Jamar on, the big fellow who's been in good form, taking a couple of big plucks up forward.
Melbourne bench looking excited at what they're seeing. Just big lead and the boys look like they'd rather be anywhere else, Brian. This is... Bartram, and he found it very hard to get out of that crunching tackle.
Bartram, I think Bartram's been with Rob Harvey most of the day, and done a pretty good job too. Kept into eight touches.
On the wing, Milne, DeVos. Voss low ball, not going to help either of the big forwards, and Carroll. Rewalt did well, but Carroll follows up, now Byron. This will open up for them. They've got the loose man downfield. Here he is, Bate.
Jim's boy.
Oh. Bate now. Driving ball. Neats won't get there. Goddard and Baker almost collide midair. Davey. Was he held? Umpire said no. Goddard now out the side door and finds Montagna. Montagna's got Acklin on downfield. But there's nothing beyond this one. They'll have to wait. Rewalt was on, but Acklin elected to go inboard. Fisher got him out of trouble. Fisher's kick is out in front of ball. Strong overhead. Did well, ball. Left foot kick around the corner. Yeah, boy. Bowled a couple of demons somehow. Swartz to Harvey. Harvey looking for support. Garrett gets there. Goes and gets it. And Fraser has nailed his second goal.
Well, a comedy of errors there. A couple of bad blues. Luke Ball first, not sure who he was going to there at all. And then both Rivers and Holland overran the footy. Rivers left his man to go and to lay the tackle. Fraser steps around Adam Uze and kicks a goal. So, not the classical piece of footy. Fraser's now got two.
That's the equation for the Saints.
You know what I reckon Fraser won out in the square against Holland is the way to go now. And get Rewalt maybe up onto that wing, running back with the fight of the footy.
Well, here's Del Santo, being their best player by a big stretch today.
Again, it's Baker inside the 50.
Your point, Brian, is beautiful, mate.
Exactly my point. Bartram kicks to a one-on-one involving Davey in the aerial position. Not going to win too many of those. Graham over the top to Harvey. Robbie Harvey. Fraser Gehrig presents for him, and there's a grab.
I'd back him against Ben Holland. Ben Holland hasn't played a hell of a lot of footy at full back. I would just try and isolate those two, one out in the goal square.
Looks like he's going to have a ping at him, the big boy. Take a good kick from outside the 50. He's pulled it right, it's working its way back, but not enough.
Uze up to 24 possessions against Stephen Baker.
Okay, here's a good look at what Melbourne will do and how they'll set up for the kick-in. Johnston just going wide to the pocket, and Bruce, they're in no hurry from this point. It's once they get to the wing that they'll perhaps start to accelerate and move the ball more swiftly, but they just want to make sure they get it out of here without air up. Bruce, wide to Robinson on the lead. Graham, good ball. McGough got rid of it a little quickly. Baker, head over it. Harvey, hasn't been his best. Ackland, umpire will now be forced to ball it upright in front of the interchange area on the wing.
He's picked out a free.
Let's go down to Chris Jones.
A little bit of mystery surrounds Matthew Whelan. He came off at the 29-minute mark of the second term, and it doesn't look like he'll play any further part in the game. Jason Blake also still on the bench with that shoulder injury.
Goddard to Revolt. Revolt low, a tumbling ball for Milne, who trapped it beautifully. The left foot snap from Stevie Milne.
At least Grant Thomas has done something here. He's got, I reckon Revolt's gone up onto the ball and pushed Milne back a bit deeper. You can't keep playing with that same pattern when you're getting belted. You've got to mix it up and change that structure up there.
32-point margin, McLean.
Slow down, he's saying. That's the signal there. Just slow down here. We want to clear the area.
The tactic, as Gary has already alluded to, that St Kilda have struggled to grapple with this year.
This all opens up eventually, doesn't it?
It does. White, it's a matter of knowing when to step on the gas and proceed forward with swiftness. White, I guess they wait to get the ball in a good position, but also in the hands of someone that can penetrate the congestion of players in front of the ball. Bartram, high ball, Swarce.
Well, that's not a good kick. You've got to get it so that J-Mark can contest and compete.
Right, let's see what happens from here. St Kilda have got the overlap player on the outside. They fail to use him. They keep the ball in the corridor. Graham turns Johnston around and finds a nice target in Blake, who just came on the ground.
So what happens now? You've got Revolt up around the middle.
Blake plays on over the top. Now ball can go again if he wants. He elects to take the set shot.
And Garrick back in the square. Schwarz runs around near the ball, so they're not sure who the ruckman is. Blake is playing on the ruck. So this defence that has been absolutely on top have now been served up a whole different set of circumstances. And just right now, they're a little confused, and it might win St Kilda a goal.
Three goals for the year, Luke Ball. And this is his first set shot at goal this year for the Saints. 35 metres out, not a difficult one. He's got it bending left to right, and that's good. Perhaps the Saints might find something out of this.
Now the challenge, and this the challenge goes back to Neil Danaher, who is probably for this first two quarters and a bit coached everything his own way. He's had everything his own way. What he's wanted to do is work. He's been in the box seat. Now there's just a few little things happening there, a couple of changes. He's got to react a bit differently. And it's a good thing. It's a good thing for the Saints.
Two in a row to St Kilda. And the margin now getting back to something that's manageable for the Saints. Harvey comes in. Goes back and gets it again.
Great effort.
Banged into by Jamar, but the clearance is all St Kilda. Montagna a couple of bounces. Runs to 50. End on end, tumbling Mung. Only Rivers there to take it.
14-3 inside 50s this quarter to in favour of St Kilda.
Well, Gary, if you're Neil Danaher and you flick the switch on this tempo football, do you run the risk of sucking the momentum out of your own players?
No, I reckon it's okay. It's just once they get forward to centre like that where they're making their mistakes.
Beckett turns that one into a win for St Kilda. And Fisher's got it on the outer side.
It does mean, though, if you turn the ball over, it's always going to be in St Kilda's half, Gary.
Yeah, well, I reckon they played the same way in the first half with better execution, and they dominated.
All right, well, here we go. St Kilda's
turned over.
Godfrey, Del Santo, Montagna, linking one over the top. Found Blake, got time to take them on. Gets around Carroll. This will lift the spirits of the Saints.
Well, it's amazing. Now they've got a bit of momentum. They've got a head of steam because they refused to allow things to roll on in the manner that they were. They changed things up. They changed it. Changed the structure. Gave Melbourne players something different to think about. And all of a sudden, he's having an impact, Blake. The big fellas are having an impact. Harvey's starting to win a bit of footy through the middle of the ground.
And they're on a bit of a roll. 15-3 inside 50s now.
Big 5 minutes for the Saints. Three goals piled on. Now it's a 20-point ball game. Jamar. High, Montagna, ground level. Gets the handball going forward, Johnston. Triple teamed, and there'll be another bounce.
Look at this St Kilda forward line now compared to what it was in the first half. There is just two one-on-ones everywhere. Just, in fact, only two of them. Revolt pushes up in the middle, so Carroll all of a sudden now, what does he do? That's a different job for him. It's a better setup.
Revolt over the top of Jamar. Del Santo.
Nathan Carroll doesn't want to play midfield on Nick Revolt. He's happy playing full back on Nick Revolt. So if he can just play up around the middle on the wing and float forward at the right time, different proposition.
There's a look at the St Kilda structure. Open forward line, all in a line. Space left and right of the key targets. Davey, did he hold it too long? Umpire said yes, so all of a sudden, those little line balls going the Saints' way.
Last 8 minutes, 40 possessions to 11 in favour of the Saints. Inside 57 and nothing in favour of the Saints.
And three goals is the net result of that. Blake to Garrick. Garrick and Holland. Gary's always liked the matchup. Just needed a bit of ball. As Harvey to Goddard. Goddard around the corner. Finds Del Santo. Now, if he were to kick this, it would be back under 20 points, a 14-point margin. And that would just about be enough for the Saints this quarter.
Harvey, this quarter has been busy. Really starting to win some of that. Just wills himself, Robert Harvey, back into a contest. Regardless of how quiet he might have been, he wills himself back into it.
A big kick to get it back within 14 points with 7 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Nick Del Santo kicks it true. He's got three. The Saints have got four in a row.
This has been much, much better from the Saints. Much more organised, playing with a lot more purpose and not allowing themselves to be dictated to as they were in the first half of footy. Fraser Gehrig a bit more involved than he has been in the first half. David Neitz now, the captain, who's been absolutely dominant, kicks seven goals, just can't get opportunity. He's up on the line saying, rightio, time to just answer the question that the Saints are asking.
Rod Butters, the president, very happy with what he's seeing.
Is he ever? They have really rallied here.
And Nick Del Santo thinking he's coming off, now he's coming back on. And
he's been the catalyst. You wouldn't be taking him off right now, I reckon.
Jamar in the centre, Blake as well. This is where they've got to start winning some footy. The D's have been smashed in this part of the ground in the last 5 minutes or so. Ball at half forward.
He's lifted to the skipper.
And there is Nick Del Santo. And he won't get the ball out of there, you won't think. Eventually the D's strip it out. Johnston to Bruce. Bruce goes back and stops it down again. Short to Carroll. He's got Holland. Nice and wide and gets to him now. Ben Holland. They've just been unable to find any of the flow that they had right throughout the first half of these.
That's pressure, isn't it? That's some more pressure from St Kilda. And they wouldn't be too unhappy with this because the man that they want to keep the footy away from is David Neitz.
Here's Ben Holland. He'll go short to Carroll. And Carroll's just got to pump it long in search of Neitz. He's got a few to beat and he doesn't. Just got rid of McGuire like he wasn't even there. This is a man who has seven on the afternoon.
Have a shot. You'd have a shot from there, the form you're in, the day you're having.
Well, maybe he's just going eyes inboard, Brian Taylor style, goes just to give someone the impression he's...
He kicked one from this exact position at the other end.
He kicks it from left to right. He brings him back.
For number eight, from long range. It might land in the square. Revolt in from the side. Lyndon Dunn had a piece of it as well. Revolt's paid the mark.
Well, they can't afford to concede here, the Saints. They've got themselves into a position where in the final quarter they can attack. They're within 14 points and A goal now against them would be bringing a lot of this third quarter work undone. Here's Fisher. Goes forward, but not a lot of thought to where he is kicking it, because look at the D's form a guard of honour around this one, allowing Johnston to pick it up. It's been a quiet day for him.
The tackling's lifted, secured it.
Got the handball away, said the umpire, and the turnover is forced now. Blake needs to get rid of it, does. Peckett, sneaky ball, wide, guard, can run. Montagna is good by Ford, lights them up, gets them within single figures.
Now, game on here. What are you made of, Melbourne? Had it all your own way in the first half of footy. Absolutely dominated the first half. Byron Pickett, the tackle was sensational. But what have they got? Because St Kilda are starting to play to their potential. In the space of, what, 20 minutes, I guess, they have just been able to claw this game back, and now within 8 points. Centre clearances, boys, 4-0 in favour of St Kilda. Clearances around the ground, St Kilda 7-1. That talented midfield group have just put their stamp on this game.
5-1, third term in favour of the Saints. They trailed by 36 points at half time. McDonald, long ball forward, Robertson just the one hand. The bounce of the ball going the Saints' way, Graham just tumbled it in Stevie Baker's direction. He's wrapped up in a tackle. Neitz gets over there, tries to stiff arm Fisher. Maguire picks it up. His ball forward, going to land in open space. Revolt's got a couple to beat. McLean, handball inboard to McDonald. Stepping around, he goes for the long ball to half forward. Godfrey with a couple to beat. Goes back and gets it. Handball good to Lyndon Dunn. Compose yourself, young man, and miss to the right-hand side. And they can't buy a goal now, the Demons.
He could have kicked that in the first half with his eyes closed. Lyndon Dunn, that's the sort of half Melbourne we're having. But now it has been turned right around.
A 13-minute period for the Saints here has netted them 5 successive goals. Peckett, Johnson, Uze. 3 minutes remaining in the quarter. The Saints can't afford to concede. They would be very happy the position they're in at the moment. Bait says, okay, boys, let's slow it down. Under 3 minutes remaining.
I'm not sure about whether you'd be slowing it down from here. That would be the criticism of this style. He's got to go now.
9-point margin. Saints would be really happy with their work from here. Bruce. Neitz offers no lead. In fact, the only lead came from Davey. The other boys are just top of the goal square.
Revolt getting back now.
What can Neitz do? Up they go. Done!
Look, even more reason to get it in quicker. Then just missed one now, Lyndon Dunn. He's a good kid, as we've said. He's just got to go back and drill the goal to give them some sort of, well, breathing space, composure. Coming up to three-quarter time.
It's a 9-point margin as we have it at the moment. This, if successful, sees the Demons in front by 15 points with under 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Dunn comes in. Only about 10 metres out. He's got that one. The Demons by 15 points with a minute and three-quarter remaining in the third.
Still got winning forwards. That hasn't been their fault that this thing has been turned around to the extent that it has. But it's just been, well, they've been beaten in the midfield, beaten at the stoppages and the clearances. And the defenders have been under siege as a result. But the message now would be at three-quarter time, certainly, we've still got a forward line that is on top. Let's get it forward to centre, move it very quickly and give them a chance.
Much needed goal for the Demons, provided by a good young player in Lyndon Dunn. White gets pounded into. Well done. Back by Blake to Harvey. And Harvey to Revolt on the bounce. Gets the handball off to Fiora. Dangerous left foot delivery from this player. Long ball touched on the line. Oh,
Oh, they stopped.
The umpire says it's hit the post.
Hit the post.
And behind the result.
Luke Ball has been quite superb this quarter. Let's have a look at it. Well, it did hit the post. Had 11 possessions and 2 clearances.
14-point margin here in the hands of the Demons. And this has been the order of the day in this third quarter. What you're seeing now is exactly the way they've played the entire quarter. They haven't played it well. It's probably the right tactic, but it's conceded 5 goals to their own 2 in this quarter. So the result hasn't been what they're looking forward.
30 more touches for the Saints this quarter. Now, this is not so bad. It's just someone's got to go at him. The Saints player's got to go at him.
White.
What they're saying effectively is we are prepared to take you, or happy to take in, 14-point lead at three-quarter time.
Holland will go back and milk it. They would know well and truly. The Melbourne runner has been out several times, that there's only be a lot of time, 20-odd seconds left now, and I can see Rodney Grinter, the Melbourne runner down there, saying, boys, steady it, that'll do it.
Regardless, they've got themselves back in the game, haven't they, the Saints? Right back into the game.
14-point margin is going to be the three-quarter time margin. The Saints would be very happy to trim it from 36 points at half-time to the current 14 points. The Saints fans take a sigh of relief and say to themselves, well, we are back in with a genuine chance. We can go and regroup, regather our thoughts and get a rub and feel good about ourselves coming into this final quarter.
Psychology of footy. They might go in. The message now is, hey, we've got them on the back foot here. We've slowed them up. We've narrowed the margin. So momentum a bit with the Saints here at three-quarter time. They go away. 14 points to the margin in favour of the Demons.
You could spend hours searching for the weekend's best quarter of football, but why bother? Fox Footy's already done it for you.
McLeod for another one! Yes! Chance for Melbourne! Bruce! Oh, he's got it at last!
The Crucial Quarter, Monday on Fox Footy Channel.
Harvey Norman's Tax Time Essential Sale is on now with a huge range of notebook computers at hot, hot prices. This compact Presario, only $986. A huge range of multifunctions and printers, starting with this HP. Print, scan and copy for a red-hot $49 after cashback. Hot deals on all your software needs, like MYOB Accounting Plus, reduced to $487. Home or office, now's the time to save with our Tax Time Essentials catalogue out now. And remember, we won't be beaten on price.
Another moment of genius from Toyota. Most memorable grand final moment of all time. Specky of all Speckies, taken by another
Jezza!
Man. Alex Jezelenko.
Jezelenko!
Dave, it's 1970 Blues versus Pies. Now, Jezza, you stand here. I'll be Mackay. And Dave, you can be Jerga Jenkins. You happy? It's not... Dave. Dave, that was a really good suit. You've lost a little bit of the spring in your step.
Spring!
But I think all we need is leverage.
A little bit of leverage for Jezelenko! You beauty! Oh, Jezza!
What could go wrong? Nothing. No, that's not going to work. Not much height there.
Oh, it's time for plan B.
That's beautiful.
Mackay kicks it to the wing position. Oh, Jezza!
Jezza! You beauty!
Hey, boys, boys.
Yes!
In trouble was Uze. He improvises! He improvises and makes something out of nothing. It's a goal!
And Osbert loved the chicken and ranch salad.
Calamari prime rib.
Beautiful. Wednesday on Headliners. It's 1986 and the WA State League is financially dependent on transfer fees from BFL clubs for names like Hunter, Bacanara and the Cracker Brothers.
Virtually all the clubs were ticked and solvent.
Then the vision for the West Coast Eagles is born.
So we had to be a prime driver of bringing about a national comp.
The West is in, but a $4 million licence fee is due within 30 days.
The BFL clubs never won the national competition, they won the money.
The birth of the West Coast Eagles. Wednesday, exclusive to Headliners.
St Kilda the better final quarter team. They've won seven and lost one. Mind you, Melbourne have won seven and lost two, so they're both pretty good in the last stanza. Only the one drawn quarter for the Saints, getting them over the line in that equation. But let's get it started. It is going to be enthralling to watch. Pickett is wrapped up.
Now the Demons, of course, headed back from Subiaco Oval. They are 50-50 following interstate matches. Not sure it has such a bearing on footy these days. Players are coping with their travel better.
White. Picked up by McDonald. Steps through wonderfully well. But now he's got nowhere to go. He has to bounce. Opens up the ground though now for Neitz to get on the end of this. Just a bit strong with the kick. Maguire and Neitz. Neitz handball to himself beautifully well. And then the snap on goal for number 8. He's missed.
Ooh, he's hot. He got no opportunity in the third quarter, and he went inside Melbourne's forward 50 about 5 or 6 times. He kicked one magnificent goal.
Was it Melbourne that starved him of opportunity in the third quarter, or the Saints that starved him of opportunity?
The debate we had at three-quarter time is a good one. A little bit of both, I would tend to suggest, but I would put it more down to the Saints. Although
this is a man in red-hot form, Gary. How can you not want to get him the ball?
Yeah, well, I reckon St Kilda's pressure went up a notch.
Okay.
7 inside 50s they had in the third quarter.
There's Baker. Getting very dark here at the MCG. Lights not on. As Holland happy to sweep that to the safety of the white line.
Now James McDonald got the big job on Nick Delsanto. McDonald himself had 20 possessions, being good. Delsanto, the class act out there along with Uzo. I'd reckon Delsanto 20 touches.
The Saints wouldn't want to concede the first goal, having conceded one near the siren. The third quarter just would stop their momentum. Gary!
Ben Holland's not a fullback. He's a powerful unit, but he's not that comfortable at fullback. And I'd say that Fraser Gehrig's a far better full forward than he's a fullback. And that's a matchup that I reckon could have been exploited perhaps a little earlier.
But to get them back within 9, Gary.
Yeah, Revolt up around the ground, moving up around half forward, better move as well.
Fraser to kick his third goal at the punt road end. Ooh. That one's gone across the face and they miss. The big man not happy. And his scoring accuracy in the top 10 is not where you want it to be.
The worst of any in the top 10. That disappointing, isn't it? Yeah, you need that up. You need that momentum build early in the last quarter.
Carroll to Bruce. That scoring accuracy with the big fellas closest to goal should be very, very high as well, because most of their shots are, you know, in the 0 to 35 metres out, aren't they?
Absolutely.
When you get the ball into the hands of your big forwards, they're only 30 out, and you miss. It can be a bit of a pin into the balloon as Carroll will go dangerously. Revolt came in and made a really tough go of it. Pickett over the top. Schwartz can close on 50. Still, he's got Fraser if he wants to go to him. He does so now. It's through the hands. Delsanto steps over the line. It'll be thrown in.
Well, they've got to find some run, Melbourne. It's just all dried up. All that midfield run that carried them, served them so well.
Jamo, they're warming up on the bench. He's played just 38% of this game so far. Here's Gehrig. What can he do? Very heavy traffic. Graham, just as he was disposing of the ball, slipped over. I wonder whether they'll use Jamo much in this quarter, given the fact only 38% and one possession so far. Chris Jones.
They listen to your BT, the lights are on at the G.
Okay, powerful. He is a powerful man, Bryson.
Mm. Very dark. Free kick going Melbourne's way. Jeff White happy about that.
Well, half forward now. What are the Demons doing at centre half forward? Who's the target, the push-up target?
Well, looking at this, Gary, they're going to play the same game as they did in the third quarter. You can just tell by White's body language that he's prepared to wait for something to present up. This time he drives it a little longer though, and St Kilda getting back in numbers. Harvey, stolen, Travis Johnston looking for something in the middle, a man that can create. Johnston can run. He's a smooth mover when he starts hooking. Robinson needs a sitting bounce. Hudson was desperate. Davey to Neitz. Neitz is marked. Well within range.
That's what they've got to do. Travis Johnston is the other one that you've got to get the footy in the hands of, because what he does, he comes in the middle of the ground and it opens up
the whole other side of the ground, if you like, which gave David Neates so much room to move into.
For goal number eight, Neates, from a very, very comfortable distance and angle, really gave it everything. Left nothing behind. He has eight.
Well, don't worry about this. Single-handedly, David Neates.
Mm.
Single-handedly has he, well, first of all, opened up the lead, and now he's preserving it on his own. Eight goals, all the rest are singles. It's just has been a stunning performance from the big man on this, well, the most historic of days in the Melbourne Footy Club's history for a long time.
Neates has eight goals. Has been just a standout performer as Bruce at the back of this exchange gets the handball off to Johnston. Johnston to Johnson. This man's been good. Back to Johnston. He kicks it into Johnson. I don't want to say those two names any more times. There's a locked up ball and Johnson picks it out of there and hands it to Godfrey, who's claimed in a very good tackle. Brock McLean tried to come through. Montagna slapped it to Johnston. And he goes to Jeff White, who'd snuck forward.
That emphasises your point, Brian.
Yep. Now Robertson in the pocket. They've steadied the Demons.
That point being that no matter how many times Stevie Baker gets it, he's got a heart as big as the MCG. You get it in the hands of someone like Johnston, and something happens nearly every time.
Russell Robertson will take a very good kick from here. He settles over the task now. And the kick is on the way, and it's narrow. Three for a behind.
Just started to have the last 4 or 5 minutes started to win more footy. Travis Johnston and James McDonald, these blokes around the middle of the ground. McLean also.
Rewalt. 21 point margin as we speak. And the Saints, through Fisher and Del Santo combining in their back half, they're in no hurry at the moment. They're going to have to kick four goals to win the game, which they are capable of. Rewalt really probably should have grasped that mark. Bell in trouble, tackled, turnover. Saints with Voss. Voss kicks downfield looking for ball, but McLean did well to work him under the ball a little. Brock McLean, what a player he's been for the Demons this year. He's just given them that added aggression and ball-winning power through the midfield. And this man alike, Byron, has had a great year.
That may have just got to Bell on the full, it has. Now White, dangerously. Schwartz comes in and breaks it up. He's got to square the footy, you'd imagine. Harvey standing there. Godfrey closes him down. And Byron steps on through. Off to McDonald. Numbers back in front of him for the Saints. So McDonald stops, handballs to Jared Rivers. Now Johnston.
Oh, yes.
Johnston, nicely done. To Godfrey. Neates has eight. Godfrey. Kick won't reach that far. Well, and a disappointing result in the end.
Simon Godfrey is one of those perhaps in the Baker category.
Well, this is Goddard slapping it through. And Revolt will get the handball off. And the skipper has it.
Just lacking direction at the moment. The Saints, they need someone that can grab it, run, break the line and penetrate.
There he is.
Here he is. Del Santo's capable of that. What will he do? Look at the opening handball. Found Graham. He's looking for running support. None there. The spinning pirouette move around Byron. And the chiseling ball to Swartz is marked by White.
Well, you got Big Fraser up there at the front of that square against Jared Rivers. I'd be happy to go and punt it up there.
White Sends it deep and wide.
I think Revolt's going to go back now. He's had his run round forward. If the Saints want to win this game, they're going to send him back maybe to centre-half forward, centre-half full forward.
McDonald, they're starting to get the ball in the hands of the people that can really create and dispose and make something happen now when they play this style, which is really important. McDonald wide to Holland. Holland probably wouldn't fit into that category, but you wouldn't expect him to playing as a wide player. It's the ones in the corridor that need to be multi-talented.
Oh, yes, you are on fire today, Brian. Some of your very best work.
Del Santo for the Saints.
Only Fisher ahead for him. He threads the needle and gets to him. Fisher, 60 out.
Well, someone's going to stop this rot. It's as simple as that.
To Voss. Voss gets it and kicks a beautiful goal.
And there he is. I'm not sure I've seen Brian in better form than this, Jim. He's doing calling and special comments at the moment.
Making us both redundant. Yes.
Normally I get a bit territorial over the comments, but today they have been on the ball. He summed up Ben Holland beautifully. He said, not the man you want the footy in the hands of. And what did he do? He flipped it over in the middle of the ground and it came back down the other end. Got it into Brett Voss. It went back and slotted it. They've got to be a bit more precise.
The Saints are back. They're within 15 points of the Demons with lots of time left. Clock not working here at the scoreboard at the G, but it is on our screen with 11 minutes remaining. The Pigeons are settling in. They think it's over.
Ooh, he's doing colour too, Jim.
Just a little taste of what can happen, Gary, when you share the workload. Driving ball, Schwartz over the top. Where's the ground level player for the Saints? Who will arrive? Fiora committed the body. Great stuff. Voss. Milne. No mark. Handball. Fiora on the right.
Just the minor score. Cheers. Good effort. Good effort over here on the boundary line. Good effort by Milne to stand up. Left footer, of course.
Question for you about Revolt, Gaz. Is this the sort of situation where, as an emerging champion, he's got to step up and take three or four big grabs and win a game for his club?
I reckon it's fair. And I'm a massive, massive fan of his, but yeah, I reckon that's a fair call, Jim. I'd say now's the time maybe to go back, even deep, and just say, righto, you win it for us.
Yeah. If you're going to be a Brown or a Carey or, you know, mentioned in that sort of breath, you've got to just conjure up a way to win a game for your club as a champion. Yeah, that's what he is.
What he's doing is he's being a mobile floating, and that was good in that third quarter to move it up. But now he's got to go and get the ones that matter most.
Long from Fisher. Here he is. Oh, he had a piece of it.
Gee, he did too.
Over the top, Del Santo. This is Goddard now. They're pressing hard, the Saints. Around the corner from Goddard.
Oh.
And that's away, four behind.
Oh dear, they've had some chances here. They're doing all the pressing. But the Demons have got to, I think they've got to push the button here themselves and really take the game back on.
Exactly 10 minutes remaining in the quarter. A 13-point margin.
Huddling up they are, as you can see. At about 35 metres out, trying to free one up.
Good look at the options for Travis Johnston.
He's a good user, Johnston. Doesn't go outside the corridor. In fact, rarely goes outside the corridor.
Bait. Looked like he was going to kick it long and then just tricked him. And just took a lot off the boot and went wide and short. Now Rivers. Contest forced. Just what the Saints wanted. Bruce. Johnston. Couldn't quite get a full purchase to Neeks. He is white hot at the moment. Back to Bait. Gone, dropping the ball. And the advantage not paid there. It'll come back and it'll be a Del Santo ball.
Wonder if they sense this, St Kilda. If they sense it, they're a huge chance here. They've got
on
all the momentum.
They get it to him. And ball forward from that player to Graham. Graham to pump it long in the Gehrig direction. They go back hard to the Melbourne defenders. And a missed opportunity as Bell gets it out of there. Dangerous ball, beautifully marked by McDonald.
He is a very, very good player, this bloke. He's in a stack of the footy, but he does what needs to be done when the pressure's on.
Here's Uze. So quickly, St Kilda have manned up their opponents, which is a very good sign, and they'll force another contest, although Uze will go backwards now to Holland.
Stephen Mills, he's got to stand up. He slipped over three times. He's got to do something.
Johnson. Now, the only player not manned up on the field at the moment is Holland, and he's gone wide to the boundary line. So that's the bailout ball for Johnson if he's got nothing on downfield. Forced to kick to the contest again, so St Kilda have a win there. Jamar, McLean and Bruce. Davey, what sort of acceleration has he got? He's got 20 metres to pick it up cleanly. Get back on the left. Standing start to the line.
Minor score. We're going to kick three goals, St Kilda. The Demons, apart from Neitz, no one else is threatening. So if they can close him down, maybe drop one back onto him, then go all out attack.
Graham. Kick to himself. Look out. Oh, dangerous play back there. Montagna now.
What am I doing?
He's got nowhere to go down the field unless it's to Nick Riewoldt, who's hit up and he'll get it. Provided the kick's good, and it is.
Need some runners. They need run. They need to run from carry through the middle of the ground.
Looking at them in the middle, Gary, they're all very tired, the St Kilda players.
Fisher and Ball has been great. You just wonder if it's taken some sting out of them in that third quarter.
Blake. Okay, back to Del Santo. Long ball from that player. Carroll wrestles with Big Fraser. Milne gets involved here. Holland shoved a handball out in the McLean direction. Rock McLean in front of Pickett was clever. Byron steps on through with blistering speed and power. Two bounces, three bounces, four now. Inboard to Bate by hand. This will really hurt the Saints. Bate loads it up on the left. It's going. It's there.
Oh, that'll be enough. That will be enough. Byron Pickett, Fisher, the man here. Now six, number six. Once Byron got past him.
Look at this. One bounce with the left, one with the right. Another one with the left.
Just Brian, you're picking everything up today.
Multi-skill.
You are just picking everything up, big fella. Beautiful finish from Jim's boy, Matthew Bate. Just on Fisher out here in front of us, without being super critical, he had to either back off and just treat some water and not allow Pickett pass. I know it's tired, you're tired late in the game, but they're pivotal moments.
Electric run from Byron Pickett, setting up the bait goal. McDonald doing the hard work in the middle. Uze, Travis Johnston made the heavy traffic look light. Del Santo spun out of the Byron tackle. Riewoldt couldn't hold it. Needed him to stand up. Gary and James spoke about that. Jamar. Montagna can burn him off. Jamar did really well. Excellent work by the big man. And now the Demons go to Uze. Elevation on the wing was not enough. Melbourne going forward again. Packer, will he charge at it? The Demons at the moment have got control of the game. Done to McLean. Blake, did he infringe by pushing forward? Yes, he did.
Well, I think Melbourne look fitter. They look just stronger. Some of the Saints boys up and down the one spot, I know it can look like that when you've got control of the footy. But they gave everything in that third quarter. And I'm just wondering whether it took some sting out of them, because the Demons, they are finishing much stronger.
Now Bader here, backing himself from a long, long way out. 55. And just a tired kick. Travis Johnston wanted it earlier in the preparation, and he refused to give it.
Now, Nick Riewoldt's inside defensive 50 at the moment, inside Melbourne's forward 50. That's not where you want him now. I mean, that's not where you've wanted him for the last 10 minutes. He's got to go deep forward and do what Jim spoke about. Try and grab three big marks and put them back in it. Baker.
Hudson, and there's Revolt. Just pumps it long. Voss. Fist from behind by the Melbourne defence. This is Pickett. Voss gets back into it. Locked up footy, and it'll be bounced. Let's go to Chris Jones.
Well, Brian mentioned that the score wasn't working at either end of the scoreboard. There's the time clock you can see there. The people here in the stands have absolutely no idea how long is left.
Goddard, Voss, Fisher, well done. Handball off the ball. The skipper slots it forward to Schwartz. Must go out of this, the Saints. Makanu, fearsome work for the Melbourne defenders. Montagna steps up, around the body, bouncing in the square. Schwartz kicks a goal.
That's his second choice. Schwartz played as a mobile forward. Is there time? 4 minutes 40. Time just gone up on the scoreboard here. So now the crowd know that it's ticked over 20 and a half minutes. Good effort though. He's kept up. He kept trying. Got up. Second, third efforts. It's just clearance now becomes important. So Del Sando, the critical player inside centre square here.
It's a goal for goal last quarter. The Saints are within 14. And we've got just under 5 minutes remaining. McLean. Travis Johnston. Baker. Got a hand on him. Forced the ugly kick. But Travis Johnston following up his own work. Turns around and fights Dunn. Now Dunn kicks the goal. It's over. He'll play on and move the ball out towards Byron. And Byron will take the mark. And line up from 30 out on not a difficult angle.
Well, you talk about the cream. Travis Johnston, 10 possessions in this last quarter. And every one of them being of the highest quality. He's the man that gets the job done for Melbourne and gives them scoring opportunities. Del Santo's had 8, been sensational in the last quarter, in fact all day. McLean and McDonald, 7 apiece, also been terrific all afternoon.
He's kicked the 3 goals for the Demons this year, this man. And he's played a lot of his footy off halfback. Pickett comes in to ice the game for Melbourne. I think that's it now, a 20-point lead.
That will be enough, and it's a very good win, I reckon. They had a period of time in that third quarter where they, well, just lost themselves, but they're good enough to keep attacking the game. And once they do, they can score pretty heavily, Melbourne, I reckon. Their forward line has always looked dangerous. They've got the job done today without any great contribution from Russell Robertson and Aaron Davey. They're a good side.
Demons with all the answers. And it looks like time may be the enemy now, the Saints. White, Bruce and McDonald, but it's Milne with it. Back inboard he goes. Looks in the Voss area. Good mark taken by that player. Got to go back and kick it. Not a lot of time left.
You've got to be a chance.
From outside the 50, it's high. Good luck marking that. They'll have a dip at it. Schwartz has got to concede with the fist. McDonald steps through to Holland. Holland's little left foot ball bouncing in front of Brock McLean. Luke Ball's there as well, and that's off the shin and over the line.
How good's Brock McLean's last 5 or 6 weeks been a footy for Melbourne? Just superb. For a young man in his third year, he's had some injury problems. He's a quality player.
Blake, McDonald, and the man Gary speaks of, McLean, Rewalt, a bounce, true centre-half forward, is he in range on his non-preferred side of the open goal square? Magical start, Rewalt gives them a glimmer of hope.
2 minutes 40, seen some extraordinary things this weekend, in this weekend's round of football already. Is there hope? What is there? 14 points, they'd have to score 3 goals. It would be up there with, well, it wouldn't be the most extraordinary thing that's happened, but he's a class act. When we talk about him, we're not ever questioning his ability, Nick Rewalt. We're just, well, sometimes you'd like to see him go forward and pluck those big ones, but he's a star.
Beautiful running goal from Rewalt on the left. to give his side some sort of hope. They must get a clearance here. White got the hand on it. Brock McLean just hooked it out of there. Got it to half forward. Lyndon Dunn. Fisher with him. Dunn's got a hand on it. Off to Robertson. Robertson to Bate. Not far enough. Bate on the left. It's at the right end of the ground now if you're a fan of the Demons. And it's over the line.
Well, what have the Saints got coming up? Six wins, four losses. They'll be big one against the Swans and, the Crows. Painful. And Collingwood as well in that next four rounds of footy. That is a tough 4 weeks ahead.
Ball, got one high, we'll get a free. Obviously don't rate Hawthorn that highly, Gary. You need to mention them in the third week.
Well, I think those other three sides are positioned in the top four, Brian. That's what I was getting at. And the Hawks are just struggling a touch, you're right.
The Saints have had a quality list to choose from. Although they are down on injury at the moment as Maguire takes a specky. And we mustn't forget that about St Kilda missing a number of their stars. Baker, the rundown was great. Here they go. They're winding up the Saints. Goddard, fast hands Voss. Oh, goes out wide. Chance here for the Saints. Hutchton said, I don't want it. Fiora, do you want it? No one wanted it in the end. Why Fiora wouldn't go for home? Neither of them wanted to get it done.
Kick the goal. Go and kick the goal.
I can understand Max getting out of the way and allowing the talented Fiora by foot to do it.
Blake. Bate. Bruce and Goddard. Goddard did well. He did really well. Dal Sando inside the 50 with a probing ball to Schwartz. And I think it carried. That's Carroll. Now Goddard, Godfrey. And he missed the body of Bruce, but it's not going to matter. The ball's over the line. And those gentlemen in there, while they'll be very worried, will think that they've probably done enough.
Talk about big games, boys. Next Monday, Queen's Birthday weekend. Melbourne versus Collingwood here at the MCG. Get in line for your tickets early on Monday because that could be the game of the year.
Harvey gets it to Schwartz. He's got to go back and kick it.
Assuming they hang on here. But he's better off. The thing about St Kilda, they have not turned it up one bit. They were ordinary. Horrible, in fact, in the first half. But their second half has just been full of endeavour.
Got to get the ball quickly to boot. Try and snaffle this and get it back in the centre. For number three on the afternoon, that's not going to get there.
Brian, what are we looking at? You've done everything today. You have absolutely been sensational. What sort of crowd would you anticipate Melbourne Collingwood? Queen's birthday, good day, magnificent MCG.
In a time of need, I had to do everything, Gary, but next weekend or next Monday, public holiday. Melbourne in some nice touch at the moment, Gary. Collingwood in unbelievable touch at the moment.
Well, just give me a figure, please.
I think we're going to see in excess of 70 next week, without any doubt.
Yes, I thought you might come up with something a bit better than that.
Potentially 90 if everyone on the given day decides to say, well, I'm not going to go, you know, shopping or...
It's worthy of an 85,000 crowd next Monday.
Well, I think that's what I said, between 70 and 90, Gary.
And it's been a big day here at the MCG. This bloke being superb, I tell you what, he's just emerging as the quality midfielder.
Robbo won't get it done here, siren sounds. 13-point victory for the Demons.
Well, it is a grand old flag, and that man is the story of the day. Not that one, that one. Number nine is the story of the afternoon. Big build-up goes past Robbie Flowers, the game's record holder. There he is, the great Robert Flower. What a magnificent man he is. And the St Kilda players getting over to David Neitz, and that is a nice touch as well. Just acknowledging what is an extraordinary performance. On top of that, he's come out today and played one of the great games. He belted St Kilda almost single-handed and slotted through 8 goals. was superb, did it all in the air and on the ground. And well, Chris Jones was always going to interview David Leitch if Melbourne won, but it's nice to do it on the back of a BOG 8 goal performance, Jonesy.
It certainly was the best on ground performance. It was a very tough opening unit, really, wasn't it?
Look, it was fantastic. You know, the boys were magic today. The pressure we put on the Saints was just excellent. And awesome day. Really proud of the team individually, and to have a great win like this is just magnificent.
What about the 8 goals, though? I mean, you were absolutely on fire.
Yeah, it's nice with 273 under the belt to still be able to kick a few goals and play well. So that was really good, really good.
What about this day for you? From the minute you turned up, the fans were on their feet before the game, and they are again now.
Yeah, look, the support was magnificent. I came in about an hour or so before the game, and they were all up on their feet. So they're just magnificent from the Melbourne people, and I really thank them for getting behind me and supporting me.
And what does it mean personally to you to beat Robbie Flowers' record?
It's excellent to beat Robbie Flowers. No, look, Robbie's a legend of the club, and his status is right up there at the top. And to be up there among those names is a great feeling.
Well, congratulations. Go and enjoy it, mate.
Great, thank you.
We'll get some sort of an ovation when he comes off, I would have thought. And
he just oozes good bloke, doesn't he?
He's a ripper. And I think we said this a couple of weeks ago, but it bears repeating. Humble, modest, self-effacing, and the boys love putting a bit on him, and he just wears it beautifully. But when it comes game time, Jim, there is none more focused and harder at it than him.
No, and he's copped a bit this year. A few people have potted him, saying that maybe the end is nigh, but geez, today he was fantastic.
Put them right back in their collective boxes. There weren't that many of them. There were a couple that have got him wrong. He's a beauty. And apart from that, it's a very good win for Melbourne against a side who's been, well, penciled in as one of the premiership fancies. And they've come here on Melbourne's home ground. And they've dispensed with them. And their younger players keep getting better, Brian.
They do indeed. I just watching David Neitz do his work, very modest, as you say, was reluctant to go out towards the crowd, and his teammates have now encouraged him to do that. A big day for the Demons today, Gary. They've won by 13 points.
It was, and paid him the ultimate respect. That's what you want when you have a milestone game. David Neitz acknowledges the support of someone special, I would imagine. The Demons over the top of the Saints by 13 points.